got my nickname in high school. Me and a buddy were boxing, and I knocked him out. And now I'm NyQuil Nate.
Sandman, baby. Put you to sleep.
Friends, a few people who've seen me in the crowd, they see that I like to knock people out, stand up. So they like to call me the Sandman because I like to make people go to sleep.
I'm excited to fight him because, you know, he's a guy, he's finished every fight he's been in, you know. I don't think he's ever been to the second round, and I'm just excited for that challenge. I finished all my fights. You know, we're two guys who go out looking to finish each other, and it's going to be a war.
I'm excited to fight Nate. I respect him. I know he's an overall balanced contender. I mean, trains out of a good camp, Miletic. I have a lot of respect for Miletic. I know he's a tall guy. I mean, he's going to come in. He's going to want to stand up, take me down. I don't care wherever the fight takes me. I'm ready for it.
I just hope he knows he'll be in for a fight. I hope everyone comes out to see it. It's a stacked card, a lot of great fighters on it, a lot of big name fighters on it, and it's going to be an exciting show. Come out and see it.
Cage Aggression 12 making his way to the cage. Jordan the Sandman Sanford representing Hard Drive MMA in Cedar Rapids, Iowa, with a record of 1-1. And this is for the 185-pound title.
Getting a chance to talk to Jordan before the fight, he was saying that, you know, it's the best camp that he's ever had. And I guess we hear that a lot, but he also, you know, talked a little bit about his diet. You know, how important is diet and, you know, being able to get to a right weight? But being able to get to that weight the right way.
Diet is discipline. I mean, and that's what it comes down to. There's nothing more important other than the training itself than what you eat and what you put into your body at the right time, before training, after training. I mean, it sucks because your snacks are apples and this and that, but it all pays off for when you get into the cage. Making his way to the cage in our eighth fight of the night here at Cage Aggression 12, NyQuil Nate Rodriguez with a record of 6-1, representing MFS and Rock Island, Illinois.
One thing that Nate was saying before the fight was that he was looking to finish the fight, and that his opponent is probably also going to be looking to finish the fight. So we've seen the very heavy hands of Nate Rodriguez a few times before in the Cage Aggression Octagon. So, you know, it's going to be a very interesting fight to see who's able to sort of land that one shot quickly, or, you know, at some point during the fight.
And both these guys have such knockout power. So, I mean, I feel like the first minute or two, that's what we're going to see, is really throwing those bombs and seeing who can land it first and really gain the respect of their opponent.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next bout of the evening is scheduled for five-minute rounds for the Caged Aggression Professional Middleweight Championship, and is powered by Bud Light. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He stands 6 feet, 1 inch tall and weighed in at 183.5 pounds. He trains with Hard Drive MMA and is sponsored by Gary's Tattoo Parlor. Joining us from Cedar Rapids, Iowa, Jordan the Sandman Sanford. And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner. He stands 6 feet, 1 inch tall and weighed in at 184.5 pounds. He trains with Militech Fighting Systems and is sponsored by Caged Aggression. Joining us from Rock Island, Illinois, NyQuil, Nate Rodriguez.
Here we go, ready to get our middleweight Caged Aggression MMA title fight underway. Jordan the Sandman Sanford versus NyQuil Nate Rodriguez. Rodriguez in the white shorts, Sanford in the black.
Who's going to drop the bomb first? That's the question in this fight. Because you know the bombs are coming from both of these guys.
Big body kick from
Huge
Nate already.
Kick right there.
And everybody's just kind of waiting for the big shot. Another big leg kick from Nate, really getting his hips into it. Big body shot answered from Sanford too.
Big shot right there, Brian.
Good counter from NyQuil. A smile on the face from NyQuil. Rodriguez really stalking Sanford down.
Right.
Big shot.
A night of low kicks tonight.
Right.
Two nights of low kicks. But
I will say that was the best I've ever seen somebody take a low kick, and we heard the cup. And he just kind of said, yep. Got kicked.
Yep. Seeing both of these guys, you know, I really think with Rodriguez sort of coming in the way he's coming in, it might be a really good time for Sanford to use the front kick, you know, use those kicks to sort of stop that that progression that Rodriguez is using right now.
Right.
Ooh, huge shot right there by Rodriguez.
There it is. There's the first big one. Landed it big. Big knee.
Big knee right there.
Sanford is dazed. Rodriguez wants to put another one on him too and gives him
one of
his own.
Nice shot right there by Sanford.
That was a big shot that rocked Sanford.
Another big right hand right there by Sanford.
Nice uppercut from Rodriguez. Big knee. He's got him up against the cage and really looking to
end
this.
Another big shot by Rodriguez.
Right now, Sanford's taking some time to kind of clear the cobwebs out.
Yeah, and Rodriguez smartly using, trying to trip Sanford and, you know, might get a takedown that way.
And Sanford bleeding already from the nose. Nice standing guillotine right now. Rodriguez looks to trying to lock up his hands right now, create some space.
Rodriguez is going to look to get a little bit of space and, you know, unload one of those patented right hands probably. Sanford needs to make sure that he remains calm and, you know, keeps his body close to Rodriguez. You don't want to give Rodriguez any space right now.
Right. Takedown from Rodriguez, looking to take his back, spins right into a rear naked.
That rear naked looks to be in pretty tight right now.
Yep, rear naked is in deep. under the chin. Nate's gonna lock his legs up and really arch back, and he taps. It's done.
Rodriguez, you know, once again with a pretty impressive victory.
And there's the power of Rodriguez. He lands a huge shot, and he follows through with a rear naked choke, just showing that he is dangerous on his feet, he's dangerous on the ground, and then I think we're going to see some big, big things from Nate Rodriguez in the near future. Improves his record to 7-1 and takes the middleweight title home with him here at Caged Aggression 12.